Good morning and welcome to the University of South Florida College of Nursing pinning ceremony. I'm Usha Menon, Professor and Dean of the USF College of Nursing. Thank you all for joining us at this virtual event. Although it's disappointing for our graduates and our faculty that we can't experience this day in person, we're so happy you tuned in. This year, we've been living through a historic pandemic that has changed our daily lives in ways we never imagined. While incredibly challenging for all, we want to salute our students and our faculty for their flexibility and patience during this unprecedented time. Particularly, I want to commend you, our students, for your resilience. For those of you receiving pins today, what a milestone this is for you. Not only have you fulfilled your dream of becoming a nurse, but you joined the healthcare workforce in a changed world. Nurses have been referred to as the unsung heroes in this pandemic. Many of you will be practicing as new nurses in this extraordinary time. I want you to know how proud we are of you. This is your time to shine. You are smart, competent, and compassionate, and we're confident that you are up to the challenge. Believe in yourselves and know that we will pray for your safety and wellness. For those family and friends who are watching, thank you for supporting these students on their journey. We're honored to have played a part in helping you and them reach this important day. We pride ourselves in educating the nurses of the future. Nursing graduates of 2020, congratulations on your success.
In what has been a trying 8 months for our nation, our state, and our university, it brings me great joy to address you at this milestone occasion. Your hard work and resilience over the past several years has paid off. And I speak for all of us at USF Health when I say that we could not be prouder of your hard-earned achievements. You will have the privilege and the challenge of entering one of the most tumultuous times for healthcare the planet has seen in over 100 years. Now more than ever, being a nurse is both a great privilege and a grave responsibility. The world desperately needs the calm expertise and boundless compassion of nurses to stop this pandemic, restore the nation's health, and return economic stability to a society clearly in crisis. We have no doubt that you will rise to the occasion, and we are very confident that at USF Health, you have learned all the knowledge, skills, and aptitudes you need for a long and happy career in nursing. Your education has prepared you for everything that lies ahead. As you go out into your careers, remember your alma mater and your overriding commitment to provide excellent, affordable, and accessible care to everyone in need. From all of us at USF Health, congratulations to our 2020 nursing graduates.
Hi, I'm Martin Tadlock, the Regional Chancellor on the St. Petersburg campus of the University of South Florida, which is where you are. And I'm really pleased to be a part of this ceremony of the inaugural accelerated second degree program in nursing. You know, you are a great addition to this campus. I've seen you walk around in your scrubs when you were here on campus in person. I know the success you've had in your program. You are going to be an exceptional representative of this university when you leave here. And you've entered a career that is really, during this time especially, going to have an extremely important and positive impact on the lives of people. No matter where you go, whether it's local, somewhere in the state of Florida, or somewhere in the nation or world, you're going to have that opportunity to really have a positive impact on people during a global pandemic. So congratulations on this pinning ceremony and basically being the pioneers for this first-time cohort of students on this campus going through this accelerated nursing degree program. So good luck with everything, and as always, go Bulls.
Hello, I am Elizabeth Jordan, Vice Dean of the Undergraduate and Global Programs in the College of Nursing. It is my pleasure to recognize some of our outstanding baccalaureate students today. This semester, we have 133 baccalaureate students graduating from the College of Nursing. 26 are cum laude, 22 magnum cum laude, and 7 summa cum laude. the College of Nursing Awards and Honors Pin to baccalaureate students receiving university academic honors. Each pin has a charm that displays the level of academic honor obtained. CL for cum laude, MCL for magnum cum laude, and SCL for summa cum laude. Academic honors are a level of distinction with which baccalaureate academic degrees are earned based on grade point average. Students will receive their honor pins by mail in the coming days. Additionally, one of our students is graduating with an outstanding 4.0 GPA, and she will be honored during the virtual commencement with the King O'Neill Scholars Award. Congratulations, Danielle Myers. At Pinning, the college presents awards to those students who excel both academically and clinically. Academic Excellence Awards are presented to students with the highest grade point average in their nursing courses. Other awards are voted on by the faculty. At this time, I would like to recognize our outstanding students. We are very excited to present the Accelerated Second Degree Academic Excellence Award. The award goes to Jade Bowers. The VCARE Academic Excellence Award goes to Lisa Villarreal. This semester, we have had multiple students receive the RN to BSN Academic Excellence Award. They are Hala Akil Hader, Layali Asfor, Rhonda Hardy, Samantha Moctezuma. Next is the Clinical Excellence Award. This award recognizes outstanding graduates for excellent critical thinking skills, application of knowledge from class to clinical, and superb evaluations from preceptors. The Clinical Excellence Awards go to Crystal Allen, Mark Goshnell, Jeffrey Shane Ludwig, Konstantin Neverdoff, Susan Wilman. Congratulations to all our award winners.
Hello, I'm Amanda Davis, Director of the Accelerated Second Degree Pathway at the St. Petersburg campus. It is my pleasure to recognize our outstanding baccalaureate students for their service and community engagement. Commitment and enthusiasm are needed to compete in today's global nursing profession. Moving healthcare forward requires understanding and meeting community needs. It also requires that faculty, staff, alumni, hospitals, and our community partners all work together to improve health. I especially would like to thank all of the students who served with various student organizations, including the class boards. Because of their contributions, above and beyond the demands of nursing education, baccalaureate nursing student involvement and engagement in the College of Nursing continues to increase. Thank you all for your dedication to the college. In any group of students, there are those who stand out as role models for the profession through leadership, spirit, and service. The college recognizes these individuals through several awards each semester. The Leadership Award is bestowed upon outstanding graduates who display strong character and integrity and demonstrate a true commitment to excellence in the nursing profession. This year, the Leadership Awards go to four deserving students: Kimberly Hofer, Samantha Illis, Amanda Richardson, and Paige Sasser. The Service Award recognizes outstanding graduates for commitment and engagement in the community. This semester, the Service Awards go to Victoria Hernandez, Kimberly Hofer, Paige Sasser, Alexa Tinsley, and Amanda Zale. The Spirit of a Nursing Award recognizes excellence in all areas of nursing education and is awarded to outstanding graduates who demonstrate great passion and pride in being a Bulls nurse. This fall, faculty have selected two winners for this award. the Spirit of Nursing Awards goes to Kern George and Susan Wilman.
Hello, I am Brittany Chabalowski, Director of the Upper Division Pathway, and I am pleased to announce a special award. The Nightingale Award was created to recognize students who graciously give themselves to others and who value charity and service to their community. This award differs from the others given today in that recipients are chosen by their peers. We asked the graduating students to think of someone in their graduating class who will represent the values of the USF College of Nursing and the profession of nursing in a positive light. The votes were collected, and now they will learn who they selected to receive this award. The Nightingale Awards go to Jade Bowers and Paige Sasser. Congratulations to both of you. Well earned.
Good morning. I am Alicia Rossiter, Military Liaison for the College of Nursing. We would like to now acknowledge and show our respect for a special group of graduating students. These are our VCARE students, as well as all military veterans, ROTC cadets, our current members of the armed forces. These students will receive a College of Nursing challenge coin by mail. Traditionally, challenge coins are given to prove membership and to enhance morale within the military. The College of Nursing challenge coin bears our seal on one side. On the other side is the United States flag with the word Restore Lives, research and education to rehabilitate and restore the lives of veterans, service members, and their families. These illustrations showcase our unity as a college and also our commitment to restore the lives of our service members, veterans, and their families through our efforts. In addition, the VCARE students will receive the VCARE coin signifying graduation from the VCARE pathway. The VCARE pathway is a highly selective program for medics and corpsmen that builds upon their military healthcare education, training, and experience, and provides a more efficient pathway and education ladder from veteran to student to baccalaureate prepared nursing professional. You now join a community of more than 100 medics and corpsmen who have graduated from the USF College of Nursing VCARE pathway. To those students who will be receiving a coin, we hope that you will display or carry it proudly. We feel very fortunate to have a military presence within our student body. Your commitment to excellence and outstanding service resonates throughout the entire USF College of Nursing. Thank you for your service. Our next student award is the Grayscale Leadership and Excellence Award. True leaders serve and true servants lead. The Grayscale Leadership Award recognizes a USF veteran to BS and nursing student who has devoted his or her time in servant leadership. Leadership and military service is based on teamwork, accountability, system thinking, dedication, drive, higher purpose, and leaving no man or woman behind. Nursing leadership builds on these characteristics and includes compassion and competence. The recipient of this award demonstrates outstanding leadership and excellence in general nursing care, along with the promise of continuing excellence. This award is given in honor of United States Air Force Captain William Grace and United States Navy Captain Henry A. Gill Jr. Captain Grace served as a C-5 aircraft commander and died in a training accident on December 2, 1996. Captain Grace took his responsibility seriously and himself lightly and gave the ultimate sacrifice to our country. Captain Gill was a naval aviator from 1960 to 1970 and completed his career at the Pentagon. He exemplifies the core values of loyalty, integrity, and selfless service and was committed to leaving no one behind. The Grayscale Leadership and Excellence Award goes to Kimberly Hoffer. I would like to now welcome Paige Sasser, Samantha Illis, and Rhonda Hardy, who will give class remarks and present the Student Recognition Awards to faculty. Thank you.
Good morning, family, friends, faculty, and honored guests. Welcome to the University of South Florida College of Nursing Class of December 2020 pinning ceremony. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Paige Sasser, the VCARE class president. For those of you who do know me, I'm Paige Sasser, the VCARE class president. I want to start out by congratulating each and every one of you for this momentous accomplishment as we take another step forward in our nursing careers. As soon-to-be nurses, we all know a shift is never over until good charting and documentation is complete. So let's document the last 16 months of our lives. Don't worry, this won't be as long as the 600 flashcard Quizlets from Complex Health 1. You don't have to take notes. And no, The Krebs cycle will not be mentioned here. We'll keep it short and sweet. Let's get started with semester one, where everyone congratulated us on our journey into nursing and told us how fast it would go by. I remember thinking to myself, that sounds like a fib. However, it turns out they were right. Semester one went by in the blink of an eye. We survived our first exams together, where every answer was the right answer, but somehow the one we chose was still wrong. Next was semester two, the dreaded semester of complex one. We lost some sleep, some weight, some friends, and some sanity, but we managed to make it through. This was also the semester of women, child, family, where we learned that pediatrics are not just tiny adults. And in OB, we witnessed the miracle of life. And we learned that Dr. Beasley's drawings aren't necessarily to scale. This was also the semester where the world changed. We went on spring break and didn't return. We began to wear masks, and not just for Halloween. We sanitized our hands just to walk to the sink to wash them and forget about ever coughing in public again. But we got through it. Semester three came and went, and we learned the entirety of acute care nursing. We also learned the entirety of things to look out for when caring for patients with colostomy bags. Thank you for that, Dr. Chabalowski. We also went through psych mental health this semester. I'm still not sure how that made me feel. In our final semester, I think we can all agree that there was one thing we all learned, that we were ready to graduate. Looking back on these last 16 months, one thing was clear. We learned to take care of our patients by first learning to take care of each other. I feel both proud and honored to speak on behalf of this class, as this class is truly one of a kind. Since day one, we have supported each other, whether it be with an early morning coffee, a late night study guide, a hug, a socially distanced virtual pat on the back. We supported each other, we picked each other up, and we carried each other to the finish line, and now we're here. While being supported by ambitious, driven, and selfless peers has made our goals of becoming nurses a reality, the real masterminds behind our success are the faculty and the preceptors. The faculty that challenged us, prayed for us, stressed about our grades, and the fact that we changed our answers six times, probably more than we did, and taught us values and compassion that go far beyond care plans and NCLEX strategies. The preceptors that pushed us out of the tree, knowing that we would fly. The preceptors who watched us place our first IVs, even if our own eyes were closed. The preceptors who supported us during our first med pass, even when it took us 2 hours and a pen to open the medication packaging. You are the nurses that we aspire to be. Thank you for holding us to the highest of standards and excellence to make sure that we reach our full potential and beyond. I would like to acknowledge one faculty member at this time, one who has inspired us before our nursing careers began, one who welcomed us into the program on our very first day, one who taught us for one semester, but has been with us for the last 16 months. This faculty member is what we all aspire to be. Whether it be a late night email to check in, tips for studying for an exam, or to congratulate us on a semester well done. At this time, the VCARE class would like to thank and recognize Dr. Rossiter as the distinguished faculty member for fall 2020. Congratulations, and thank you for all that you have done and continue to do. So here's to our extraordinary class. Here's to our remarkable faculty. Here's to our tolerant and supportive loved ones, pets included, who understood all of the nursing lingo in this speech because it's all we've talked about for the last 16 months. Here's to the Starbucks on Bruce B. Downs for pumping more caffeine than blood through our veins in order to keep us going. Here's to Quizlet for not having a limit on the number of flashcards you can make for one exam. Though we are not able to celebrate this occasion together, I know, as we have in the past, We are cheering each other on as we take this next big step forward into our futures, into the unlimited potential that we are capable of and have prepared for as full nurses. It has been both an honor and a privilege to do these last 16 months with this exceptional group of people. We've always been told, if you didn't document it, you didn't do it. And now we have documented it. So guess what? We did it. Congratulations, class of December 2020.
Good morning, family, friends, faculty, and my fellow honorees. I'm Samantha Illis, USF St. Petersburg Cohort President. It is a great privilege for me to be able to virtually address you this fine morning and come together to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2020. As nurses, well, almost nurses, we've learned that documentation is very important. So I'm here today to document the past year and a half of our nursing school journey. No worries, guys, I'll be sure to keep this speech short and sweet, just like our online lectures. In just 1.5 years, we have gone from strangers eating in silence during our lunch breaks at orientation to close peers. We've formed bonds over stressing about acid and base imbalances and memorizing both the generic and brand names of pharmaceuticals. From choosing the correct answer on exam, but still getting it wrong because it wasn't the most correct. Together, we've experienced hardships, code browns, and the joy of when we hear fellow classmates say, "Don't worry, I haven't started that either." The delight in successfully getting the first IV stick, either in lab or on each other. I mean, just kidding, that's not allowed. And countless times of receiving our least shared answer of, "It's situational," or "It depends," for far too many questions. From turning into Dory from Finding Nemo when it comes to the supply closet in the hospitals and becoming near APA professional, this year has been eventful to say the very least. I remember at orientation, they said our lives are going to change in nursing school and that in order to be a good nurse that you'd have to be flexible and be able to adapt to environmental changes. However, I didn't really realize the importance of that until about March of this year. While I won't harp on all the changes that COVID-19 has caused our cohort, I will express how proud I am. The adjustment from seeing everyone every day in class, hospital clinicals twice a week, and lab to just virtual Microsoft Team lecture wasn't an easy change for anyone. Yet we were all flexible and overcame and adapted to the new normal. We buckled up, sat down in our homes, and attended 7 hour class days over the summer. Our cohort adopted to communicating through email chain and group meets rather in person like we were used to. Group meet proved an excellent tool to share both questions and concerns, and most importantly, to share funny baby Yoda memes to get on Ms. Davis's good side. We modified to online clinicals where we may or may not have, where I may or may not have given my virtual patient prednisone, which is a steroid, instead of epinephrine, which is a life-saving treatment during an allergic reaction, resulting in me killing him. But I guess it's better to make that mistake during virtual clinicals than in real ones, right? As some of you may know, we are the first cohort to graduate from the USF St. Petersburg campus, or any campus other than Tampa. A lot of times people equate being first with being the best. And while I am a member of the cohort, so I might be a little biased, but so what makes being first so important? First has different meanings based on the scenario. However, in our cohort's case, being first means we are making history. By all 20 of us being here today, this is a victory for FAAN. This allows more nurses to graduate from all campuses, which means more nurses are able to join the workforce each year, helping with the nursing shortage, which is especially important this year. I know that one of the parts that made the USF College of Nursing so memorable for me and so many of my classmates was the faculty we were privileged to work with. Each one of the faculty knew our names, our backstories, and took such a personal approach with each of us. In my near 20 years of the education system, I had never had a teacher or a professor care so much about my individual needs. One day, during my many visits to office hours, I inquired to this with Ms. Davis. Her answer was simple. In fact, it was kind of right in front of me. She said, "We care so much because we want you to succeed, yes. But it is more than that. We are nurses first. Just because we're educators now, we didn't lose our nursing card." And that is why, Ms. Davis, it is with a great honor that the St. Pete cohort has selected you to be the recipient of the Distinguished Faculty Award, which was voted unanimously, I must add, which I know you know us, and we can't agree on much, so this makes it speak for itself. and why I am no means qualified to give anyone here guidance, because after all, I am the one who gave prednisone instead of epinephrine. And this is kind of Ms. Davis's advice first. My hope for all the new nurse graduates is that you never lose your nurse's heart. You always remember the why behind the why you had the crazy dream to be a nurse in the first place. The why that carried you through the crazy long nights of studying and crazy early morning wake-ups or clinicals and group projects. So many group projects. The why that made you realize that you had enough empathy, mental stamina, and problem-solving abilities to make it as a nurse in the first place. All right, just a little shorter than a complex Health 2 lecture, am I right? We've always been told if you didn't document, you didn't do it. And now that we've documented, I guess that means we did it. Congratulations to my fellow COVID grads, also known as the class of 2020.
Greetings, family, friends, faculty, and fellow students. I am thrilled to have this privilege to speak to you on behalf of the university's RN to BSN program. It is a special honor for me because I achieved this goal barely out of my first year in nursing, and I had the privilege of completing it during a pandemic. The flexibility of this program has allowed me to work full-time, attend to the needs of my family, engage in self-care, and complete this program in 1 year. My circumstances were special because I accepted my transitional nursing position at the Veterans Hospital in West Palm Beach, and the online structure of the program made it all possible. Also, I am a U.S. Army veteran, by the way. Before I go on, I must give a shout out to Justine, my academic advisor. She has been like a protective shield in my left hand throughout the program. I told her I wanted to finish as quickly as possible, and she assisted me in selecting my courses to ensure all requirements were met. She also redirected my selections when she felt my combination of courses might be a bit overwhelming for one semester. Never underestimate the capacity of your academic advisor. Thank you, Justine. The professors, too, have been like ideally cut diamonds, reflecting all the life that enters them. For example, my husband suffered 2 major heart attacks 2 weeks before the end of my third semester. I informed my professors, Dr. Cairns, Dr. Lutz, and Professor Vivian, and each of them expressed great empathy and offered assignment extensions as needed. I was able to finish on time, but it meant a lot that they cared. I offer my sincerest gratitude to each of you. I am a soldier at heart, so I appreciate the order and structure of the program. I always knew what to expect and when to expect it. I received timely replies to my inquiries, and the assignment feedback was always very specific and easily incorporated. I have learned so much, and what I have learned, I have applied to my day-to-day nursing practice. I have actually feared coming off as a know-it-all to my colleagues, and I have USF's RN to BSN program to thank for that. The program has prepared me to move to the next phase of my education, which is the pursuit of my BSN to DNP in mental health and psychiatry. I am proud to be a USF College of Nursing alumna, and you all will forever be with me. As a classmate told me way back when we were taking our nursing prerequisites, "This degree is yours, Rhonda. It is something that can never be taken away from you. It will be yours forever." In like manner, you will be with me forever. Thank you so much.
Hello, I'm Dr. Tiffany Gwertney, Interim Assistant Dean of the Undergraduate and Global Programs. We would like to recognize today all of our nursing students who were inducted in the Sigma Theta Tau International, the Honor Society of Nursing this semester. From its inception, Sigma has recognized the value of scholarship and excellence in nursing practice. In 1936, Sigma became the first U.S. organization to fund nursing research. Today, Sigma supports these values through its numerous professional development services that focus on core areas of education, leadership, career development, evidence-based nursing, research, and scholarship. Although we were unable to have an in-person Sigma Delta Beta at Large chapter induction ceremony, we are so proud of your inclusion in this prestigious nursing organization. The inductees are Ashley Bowen, Rhonda Hardy, Kimberly Hofer, Jessica Ibasvaline, Caitlin Lindblum, Vladimir Lute, Caitlin Montenegro, and Amber Stern. Congratulations.
Hello, I'm Leslie Lockett, Director of the RN-to-BSN program. Individual nursing pins are rich in meaning. Each school selects symbols and colors for their school pin. The pins represent the education and services provided by the women and men who wear them. They are symbols of academic and professional excellence. All of us in the College of Nursing take great pride in knowing that another generation of Bull nurses is joining the nursing profession. Since we are all unable to present your pins in person today, you will be receiving pins by mail in the next days ahead. Wear your USF nursing pins with pride.
Cesar Aguirre, Hala Akil Haydar, Crystal Allen, Lucio Anaya, Jamie Anderson, Madison Anderson, Layali Asfor, Luyusia Atamanuk, Yusra Awad, Mallory Barnett, Kayla Baraclow, Camilla Batista, Isabel Bazile, Jacob Benditowis, Elizabeth Berry, Ada Betancourt, Savannah Betancourt, Kelly Bianchi, Kathleen Bible, Vanessa Bollinger, Ashley Bowen, Jade Bowers, Ariadna Boyd, Kimberly Brackens, Cassandra Brady, Tana Byers, Juvier Cancio, Sujeri Carrion, Melinda Carter, Taylor Colley, William Centnar, Brittany Chestnut, Lindsay Clark, Christy Cooper, Kimberly Corley, Sumer Creasy, Shantiqua Cornell, Kershana Curry, Sarah DaCosta, Ronnie Don, Lori DeCola, Amelia Dobbs, Kristen Dudas, Victor Fernandez, Brianne Ferrone, Natalie Ferrante Gennaro, Marie C. Fills, Johnny Freese, Kern George, Juan Gonzalez, Mark Anthony Gosnell Jr., Annie Greenfield, Dana Gwaltney, Felicia Hacker, Nina Hadzik, Kimberly Hanley, Rhonda Hardy, Kelsey Harmon, Kiana Hayes, Jamie Heath, Victoria Hernandez, Kimberly Hofer, Christine Holmes, Nicolette Hopkins, Jessica Ibasfaline, Samantha Illis, Amy Insua, Abir Jacob, Melissa J. Emanuela Janellis, Catherine Johnson, Bethany Jones, Roxanne Joseph, Krista Carden Thompson, Megan King, Tiffany Kramer, Jeffrey Ladwig, Lakeisha Lewis, Caitlin Lindblom, Vladimir Lute, Brittany Martinez, Cole McNamara, Corinne Mikely, Gregory Mercier, Samantha Moctezuma, Caitlin Montenegro, Habiba Musa, Danielle Myers, Konstantin Nefedov, Bin Nguyen, Marceline Nicholas, Jasmine Ojetunde, Brigetta O'Neill, Megan Palmer, Amaryllis Peak, Christina Pelos, Vanessa Pinney, Erin Pride, Janelle Pulido, Kenzie Rad, Emily Ramsey, Jordan Reagan, Ansley Reed, Amanda Richardson, Danny Rivera, Sylvia Robles, Kathy Rock, Kelsey Rogers, Sonia Roman, Jeanann Roif, Nicole Sadir, Christina Sanadi, Paige Sasser, Danielle Schmier, Christy Scott, Samantha Shade, William Seeger, Angela Simons, Carmen Skeppel, Ashley Smith, Andrea Spiritus, Amber Stern, Sabrina Subic, Emily Tam, Patience Taylor, Alexa Tinsley, Lynn Tran, Vanessa Valencia, Lisa Villarreal, Melissa Wagner, Ashley Way, Scott Weiler, Carol Williams, Tekula Williams, Susan Willman, Nicole Wilson, Latasha Wilson, Lily Warsena, Amanda Zale.
Hi everyone, I'm Cheryl Zambrowski and I'm the Director of Undergraduate Student Success. At this time, we invite our new graduates, nursing faculty and alumni, and fellow nurses in attendance, wherever you are at this moment, please stand and recite the nursing pledge.
I solemnly pledge myself in the presence of this assembly to faithfully practice my profession of nursing. I will do all in my power to maintain the standards and practices of my profession.
I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping in the practice of my calling. I will devote myself to the welfare of my patients, my family, and my community.
I will endeavor to fulfill my rights and privileges as a good citizen and take my share of responsibility in promoting the health and welfare of the community.
I will constantly endeavor to increase my knowledge and skills in nursing and to use them wisely. I will zealously seek to nurse those who are ill whenever they may be and whenever they are in need.
I will be active in assisting others in safeguarding and promoting the health and happiness of mankind.
Before we conclude this special occasion, I want to take a moment to recognize all the people who made it possible. Thank you to everyone who worked behind the scenes to record video and organize this unique virtual event. I so appreciate all of your efforts. To our new nurses, you are all now alumni of the USF College of Nursing and will always be a part of our family. Remember that the Alumni Society is here to support you as you transition from student to professional. We offer you opportunities for networking, participation in community events, and a plan to continue your relationship with your alma mater. The world you're entering looks quite different from the one when you first entered nursing school. But wherever this journey should now take you, believe in your dreams. We wish you every success life has to offer. Be safe and well. And we hope that you will always find your way back to your home at the USF College of Nursing. Keep an eye on your mailboxes in the days to come. You'll be receiving your nursing pin, a printed program, and applicable awards and other items. Thank you for sharing this special time with us. Go Bulls!
Congratulations to all the new graduates on your success. Thank you for caring for your community. As you move on in your career, I have some affirmations from Dr. Seuss I wanted to share. You have the brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who will decide where to go. Continue learning and leading, and come back and let us know what's next. Go Bulls!
So remember that when you're going in to take care of sick people, the first thing to do is to remember your exceptional compassion for that patient. Next, remember that we gave you all the skills that you need to heal that patient, so relax. And probably the third thing is to remember you're not going to have all the answers, and there's going to be times that you have to tell your patient, I don't know, and then you're going to tell them, I'll go find out what you need, and then come back and share that with your patient.
Remember that your patients may be scared. They may not understand all the technical terms that they will hear, so they will come to you for answers. So like I've taught you in class, be calm, be patient, and share all the information that you can with them.
Also, remember the families. Emotions can run really high, so keep your cool and you will be okay.
In your time off, be sure to take care of yourself. Being a nurse is a big responsibility, so relax and recharge whenever you have the chance.
You're gonna come across all kinds of opportunities as your career advances. Take advantage of it. Please take advantage of it. We want you to be successful, and we want you to come back and share those stories with us.
It was such a privilege for all of us to get to know each and every single one of you. We are better people for being part of your education journey. Good luck, guys. I can't wait to see what you do in the future.
So good luck. Congratulations. You're all going to do great.
I am wishing you a beautiful life, and thank you so much for making my life richer by being in it.
Congratulations and good luck in your future.
Congratulations, everybody, on your graduation. We cannot wait to hear about your successes.
Congratulations, good luck. Go Bulls.
Congratulations, I am so proud of each and every one of you. I'm going to miss you. I promise not to cry. And here I am. Congrats.